Welcome to our Monday's broadcast of the Gospel Truth. Today, this is my second week of sharing with you some videos about people who have been miraculously healed by the Lord. I mean, blind eyes open is what we shared last week. We've had people that have just had nearly every kind of miracles. And today, I got another great testimony to share with you, and it's going to be awesome. It's about a little girl that was born with only half of a heart, no arteries, some missing ribs. In the natural, there was no way for her to live, but man, God made a way. If God did this for Audrey Scott, He'll do it for you. Watch this.
I guess it was 2001 is when I was introduced to Andrew's ministry, and that was through my mother.
We were living on the coast, and Jamie was a stay-home mom at the time. I came home from work, and she was just showing me this book. She said, "You need to read this."
Probably in the year 2002, I got to the point where I sat down one morning and I started reading that book, The True Nature of God. And all the unanswered questions that I had over the years about who God really was, He just started explaining everything that I had questions about and backed it up with Scripture.
It was powerful, powerful words that He spoke. And we could go to the Bible and there they were, and He made it easy to understand.
It was such a revelation that God wasn't mad at me and God wasn't condemning me, and it put me on a course, on a new path, so to speak. It was in the year 2005 is when we left the Gulf Coast and we moved here to Birmingham. And in 2006, I started building my home and found out that I was pregnant with my second child, my daughter Audrey.
Jamie and I were building the house, and we found out that she was going to have a baby.
And had 9 months of normal pregnancy. Nothing was ever wrong. When I went to the doctor and had checkups, she was perfectly healthy. And so on June the 12th of 2007, on that Tuesday at 12:05 that afternoon, I delivered a baby girl, and that was Audrey. Everything was normal, everything was fine. And upon delivery, the nurse was having a hard time keeping her pink. And so she was calling for the people out of NICU to come and to help and to take her back to find out why she couldn't keep her pink because she kept blueing up. And so they came and took her back to NICU and had her back there for 30 minutes to an hour. I remember the doctor from the NICU unit coming in and had some test results.
It went from a normal pregnancy and a normal delivery to this horror story of Audrey having a lot of problems with her heart.
One of her ribs was missing, and whenever they see that, it leads them to look at the heart because normally that is in line with having some type of heart problem. And the doctor proceeded to tell me that my daughter had a heart defect. They couldn't see one side of her heart. It was either underdeveloped or they couldn't really actually see that part of her heart.
He said that Audrey has hypoplastic left heart syndrome, which was very little, if any, left heart. It did not develop it during the pregnancy.
And they couldn't see the major arteries flowing from the heart into the lungs.
And also, they suspected a total miswiring of the major arteries to her heart.
There was just a lot of different issues with her, and I remember as the doctor was sitting there relaying his diagnosis to me and my husband, there was such an anger that rose up inside of me because I knew this wasn't of God. And the only way that I would have known that at that time in my life is by being able to read the teaching and getting a hold of the Scripture through Andrew's ministry. Because, you know, at one point I had received his cassettes about God wants you well.
This is Andrew Wommack, and this is the first tape in a series entitled God Wants You Well.
He's the same doctor.
And I knew that God was a good God and that He wanted everyone well.
Prayer and God healed.
And if I hadn't have gotten that information, I would have probably crumbled when that doctor come in and started relaying all the information, because I wouldn't have had faith to stand on and had the word to stand on like I was standing on at that time. But I remember that anger rising up inside of me, and I said, I wasn't going to let the enemy get the best of me. And I thought, no, I had a normal 9-month pregnancy, so why is all of a sudden this diagnosis coming out when they'd never detected anything wrong with her heart in 9 months? And so I remember looking at the doctor after he got finished explaining to me. He asked me if I had any questions, and I said, yeah, I do.
And Jamie, she looked at him, she said, so when is Audrey coming home?
And when I said that to him, he just kind of had this look like she's in denial. She's not hearing what I'm having to tell her. And he said that she's going to probably be in the hospital for a long time. And I said, okay. I said, well, you do what you need to do as far as if you need to transport her or send her somewhere, then you do what you need to do. And at that point, when he left the room, I knew what I needed to do. And that was just stand on God's word, because I knew that was not what He wanted for her.
She said, I have seen Audrey in my spirit in the house, running around on the porch. So she just had a peace about the whole situation.
I believed that my daughter was coming home. At that time, I believed that she was coming home that coming weekend, that Saturday or that Sunday. And I said, and I see just as vividly as you were sitting there, I see me and my daughter sitting out on the front porch in my rocking chair and me rocking her, and I'm holding her in my arms. And I said, well, I'm seeing that in the spiritual realm as far as me holding my daughter and me being on the front porch of my home with her in my arms. And I said, I'm gonna hold on to that. Later on, they came and they got me out of my bed there at the hospital, because the doctors told my husband that they needed to come get me so I could see her.
Because she hadn't even held her yet.
I hadn't seen her except just after delivery, and they took her to NICU at that time, and they told them that they needed to come get me to see her.
He says, we're going to have to transport her to UAB. He says, we have her stabilized, but they are the heart experts. She must get over there right away. And he looked at me and he says, you need to go get her mother to say goodbye. And I knew what he was saying. But I would not speak death over that child.
And so the nurse and my husband came and got me out of the bed there at the hospital to take me down to the ICU unit to see her. And I remember getting down there and seeing her, and she was laid out on a table to be ready to be transported. She was a grayish white color, and she was still, and she had all these wires coming in and out of her. And I remember going up to her, and I laid my hands on her, and I prayed God's word over her and told her that by His stripes she was healed. And when I got done speaking over, I just turned around and looked at my husband.
And she said, okay, take me back to my room. She said, Audrey, I'll see you later. I'll see you soon.
And I remember being wheeled away. And as I was being wheeled back down to my room, it's like the peace of God came over me and told me, He says, now you watch me work. And so I held on to that. From the time I got back to my room, I knew that she was going to be fine, and I knew that there was probably going to have to be a process to go through. But I was standing firm on what God had put in my spirit as far as watch me work. And the scripture, I am fearfully and wonderfully made, kept coming up in me. And I thought, yep, that's right, because we're created in your image. And then on Wednesday, the next day, they went ahead and transferred her down to UAB.
And when I got into the car to follow the ambulance over to UAB, I had my quiet moment. And I was just praying, God, I know your will in her life. I know you want to heal. It's your will to heal. God wants you well. That kept coming back to my mind. And if it hadn't been for what Andrew had revealed to me in his teaching, I couldn't have held on to that. I would have spoke death. I would have I've let go of that faith. And this was the time. Is the promise there or not? Is it real or not? All you can do is hold on to promises. You can't do anything else. And then God has promised, I'll heal your child. Everyone that came to Jesus, he said, they asked him, would you heal me? And he says, I will, that you be healed. And he did. And those promises are good today. And that's what we hold on to. And then I drove to UAB. And then the doctor pulled me into a room, a really highly respected doctor at UAB. And he handed me a book. The book said, if your child has a congenitive heart defect, he said, the beginning of this book are mild cases. The back of the book are the most severe cases. And he thumbs almost to the back, last two pages. And he points out hypoplastic left heart syndrome, the same thing that the other team had diagnosed her with. And he said, the heart did not develop. We run echograms. We only see a very small left side of her heart, which means that she's not getting the fresh blood pumped out. On top of that, we cannot locate the major arteries going in and out of her lungs to her heart. On top of that, we believe when we do locate them, they're going to be in the wrong place, is why we can't find them now. And he really expected to find more problems. However, he wanted to stabilize her. They had started a chemical injection to dilate everything around her heart to keep what flow she had going. And he looked at me, he said, what we can do is in a few days, we can start heart surgery. And that just sets you back. But he started explaining the procedures, and he talks about taking the right heart, making it the left heart, putting in an artificial. I kind of got lost in it. He explained it all. Then he said, but we'll give it a couple of days to see how, watch her, get her stabilized, and we'll have a better idea of how to handle. Then we discussed quality of life with the surgery and how, odds of her living or not. And it just a peace came over me, and I looked at him. I said, "You're gonna miss it today. You're gonna miss this one." And he smiled at me. And I know doctors have to deal with parents who are looking at a child that could be dying. And he says, "I understand your position, but I know the diagnosis. I know what we have here." And I just smiled, and I said, "Okay, I understand." And he was thinking I was in denial, but I was holding on to that promise. I couldn't do anything else. That's all I could do.
There was a lot of things that my husband kept from me just so I wouldn't be overwhelmed, I'm sure. But I knew that she was going to be okay. And I had my Better Way to Pray book with me at the hospital at the time, so I remember times when I was by myself, I'd pick up that book and I would read some in it just to give me encouragement through the Word. And during that time when I was there by myself, it's like the Holy Spirit spoke to me, says, you call the helpline there at Andrew Wommack Ministries. You get someone in agreement with you besides the ones that are around you. And so I remember calling the helpline there at Andrew Wommack Ministries. And there was a lady that answered the phone, and her name was Diane.
Thank you for calling Andrew Wommack Ministries. This is Diane. How can I pray with you?
And I told her that I had just had a baby and a normal pregnancy, but they had diagnosed her with some type of heart defect. And I wanted her to be in agreement with me that she was going to be healed and well. And I remember Diane was just...
By the stripes of Jesus Christ, Audrey is healed.
Oh, the power. And the word that come out of her mouth, praying for my daughter.
So in Jesus' name, right now, I command healing to that heart to be whole, to be made whole, and I declare over Audrey that she is whole and restored as in new. And we thank you, mighty God. We thank you and praise you that there is no other God like you. We declare this done. Where two or more touch and agree, it is done. We praise you and thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
It was just, I was just like, wow. And I was in such an agreement with her as far as coming against and speaking to her heart and that it to be made whole. And I remember when I got off the phone with her, that peace was still just there, stronger than before. And I remember Thursday morning, that particular morning, I called early that morning, and I got the night nurse on the phone at UAB Hospital. And I said, "How did Audrey do last night?" And she just started kind of giggling, and she said, "She did great last night." She said, "The cardiologist came in late Wednesday evening to run another echogram on her, and when they did, they saw her heart, that her heart was there." My husband was sitting there.
And I was watching her expression as she was talking to the nurse. And then when she hung up, she looked at me with tears in her eyes and said, "They see her heart."
Just started praising God.
We started praising God, and it was just a thanksgiving.
And rejoicing, because I knew He'd heard my prayer.
God has come through on His promise.
And about that time, my OB doctor came in. And he heard all the commotion going on, and he come up to me and he says, "Well, I guess you want me to hurry up and get you out of here." I said, "Yes, I do." I said, "I want to go and I want to go see her." And so I finally got discharged that morning, and me and my husband went over to UAB, and as we got there, we got to go into NICU and see my daughter, and I could see where they had already started taking some of the wires out of her, because she had so many in her. And I remember the nurse practitioner came over a little while later and told us that that her heart looked great, it looked normal, they could see blood flow going through, like it was created to go through. And
the heart is there, we see the arteries, everything is fine.
But they had had her on a ventilator, and so on that Thursday while we were there visiting with her, they decided to go ahead and take the ventilator out of her mouth.
They started telling us, "Now we've parched her lungs with this gas that we've been dumping into her system to keep her dilated and alive, and we've have all these chemicals, so as we start removing it, she's not gonna, since they've had the respirator, she's not gonna be able to cry for a few days. You'll see her open her mouth and nothing will come out because her vocal cords won't work."
Well, they took the ventilator out, and within 20 minutes after they took that out, that child was the loudest baby in that NICU. You could hear her all over, and I thought, what happened to 24 to 48 hours of no voice? And I mean, after 20 minutes, you could hear she was just crying, and I mean, she sounded like a normal child. After all that, they kept her in the critical NICU till Friday. At that time, they had canceled all tests. They had canceled everything that they had scheduled for her and was just monitoring her, basically. She had gone from half of a heart to it being fully there, and it was just awesome to see God's work at hand. Because on Saturday, I started asking the doctors, "Okay, when can I take my baby home? Because it looks like she's going to be okay." And they go, "Well, we need to monitor for another 24 to 48 hours. And so on Monday, one of the cardiologists came over and he sat down beside us, and he was very slow to speak and chooses words wisely. And I remember him saying, "Well, I don't think you'll ever have to bring her back for any type of checkup regarding her heart."
Never have to bring this child back for any type of heart issue. There's no issue. Nothing's wrong with this child.
Because her heart's just fine. It's perfect.
No problem. It's like when God touched that child, He reversed everything. Everything that the doctors did, it was tenfold ahead of their schedule.
He said, "You have a perfectly healthy little girl and that she'll be able to go home with you tomorrow." So on that Tuesday, we picked her up from the hospital and brought her home. And when I came through the door of my home with my baby in my arms was the exact time she was delivered at the hospital the week before. So it was a week to the day that she came into the world, I was bringing her into my home.
Walked right through that door there and welcomed her home.
Perfectly healthy, fine, just a bundle of joy.
The very next day was her first visit to her pediatrician. This Holy Spirit just brought up in me, "Rib, ask about the rib." Because I had forgot about that. And then I asked him, I said, "Could you count her ribs?" So he He counted her when she was on her back, and then he rolled her over on her stomach, and he counted her, and then he rolled her back, and he looked a little puzzled. He looked at me and said, "This baby has every one of her ribs." And I just said, "Hallelujah. You know, God." He healed her. He healed her. And she's been off the growth charts ever since.
It was awesome. It was awesome just to see God work, and it just builds your faith even more when you have something to stand on, like His Word. Yeah, you are a good God. You are a faithful Father. And
praise God. Praise God.
Why not believe all the good things? So I'm very, very grateful, because if it hadn't been for Andrew's ministry and the teaching that he has put out there for people to get a hold of, I don't even know that my daughter would even be here today, because the diagnosis wasn't good. I mean, they really wouldn't given her any kind of life expectancy at all.
This is the discharge from St. Vincent's to UAB, mm-hmm. and is indicating that mother and father are aware of their daughter's critical condition.
But I'm rejoicing because my daughter is here, because I know who my God is.
Flowers.
You got yellow on your shirt?
Flowers.
What color is it?
Yellow.
Say yellow.
Yellow.
Very good.
And it's great, and it is awesome. I'm very grateful and very thankful that I have a three-year-old that's running around the house.
I've been like this, darling.
I know.
Yeah, she's three, and Audrey is, she's always fully charged.
Push me, Daddy.
Push me, Daddy.
Push me.
Such a vibrant child. She's always moving, running, jumping, singing.
Jesus loves me.
More energy than any of us have. She's a perfect little child.
I have found a joy.
That's in my heart.
Jumps over sadness. I have found a love that lights up every room.
She's just a beautiful child.
Yeah, you like that book, huh?
I have found you.
Can I have a kiss? Thank you.
God's got a lot in store for that little girl.
I have found a love that lights up every room. I found you.
There's my sweetheart. Yeah, you can mom.
You are all I want. You are all I need.
Audrey.
Everything my heart could hope for. Cause you are all I want. You are all I need. Everything my heart could hope for. We are longing for the glory of the Lord. Cause we know there's so.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so.
Little ones to Him belong.
I see me and my daughter sitting out on the front porch in my rocking chair, and me rocking her, and I'm holding her in my arms.
I'm Carlie Terradez, and we really hope that you've been encouraged by today's healing testimony. Today, Andrew is offering a new Healing Journeys Volume 5 DVD. This powerful DVD is available for a gift of any amount. You can also get this as part of the Healing Journeys package, which includes Healing Journeys Volumes 1 to 5. These five DVDs include 23 inspirational stories of people receiving their healing, of people like you and me who dared to receive the healing that God has provided for us. In this package, you're also going to receive two of Andrew's most popular books, God Wants You Well and You've Already Got It. Actually, this book is like one of my favorite. It really changed our family and just turned us right side up. With all of these things, you're also going to be able to get the new Caris Healing CD, which is titled Healing Is Here. That's really going to bless you. This package has a catalog value of $170, but you can receive all of these resources today for just $99. Healing has been purchased for you through the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Reach out today and receive it along with a priceless healing package. Also available is the God Wants You Well booklet. This is the booklet, and this is particularly powerful. It goes through the scriptures, and it logs every time that Jesus healed somebody in the Bible. Andrew would like to offer this booklet to you completely free of charge. This offer is limited to one booklet per household. But go to awmi.net to see all of the different ways that you can access these products. And whilst you're there, why not discover more product details and download additional free resources? They're going to change your life. I know they changed ours. Or call our ministry helpline Monday through Friday from 4:30 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. If our helpline numbers are busy, remember you can order ministry materials or become a Grace Partner 24 hours a day, 7 days a week through our website, awmi.net. To write to us, use the address on your screen. We really appreciate your generosity and hope to hear from you today.